Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com, and welcome back to our engine rebuild on our 2011 Polaris Sportsman 850. You know, we've already got the bottom end assembled. We've got all our gasket surfaces cleaned off and ready to go. And what we're going to do today is go ahead and get the head back on there and get it timed properly. So with that being said, let's get this thing spun around, get my gaskets here set up for the machine, and get it put back together. So let's get started. In the previous video, I'd already torqued down this bolt. That was a mistake, actually, because we should have left it out. Because what we want to verify is that we're on the compression stroke, and we want the cotter pin to be facing up, which it is. So we were actually good to go on that. We'll go and reinstall that flywheel bolt and get it torqued back down to spec. Keep in mind that is a reverse thread. All right, with that retorqued, we can go ahead and pull our chain up. Then we're going to put that other chain guide in and then get our head set on. Now you want to make sure that these surfaces are completely clean and you don't want to leave any fingerprints even on your gasket when you're getting this put back together. All right, with our chain pulled up, we'll go ahead and get our chain guide in there. We want to make sure that that hook goes on the edge. Just like that. If it weren't hooked, it would kick out right now. All right, next, we're gonna find top dead center where the two case halves meet. That match line is gonna line up on the flywheel where it says TDC right here. All right, next, wanna make sure your dowel pins are in place. The surface is clean. Just grab your gasket by the edges. Like so. All right, with the head in place, for the head bolts, we just want to oil the end of the threads. Everything is just hand tight right now. And the sequence that we're going to need to get these tightened down is going to be like this. It's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this is actually a two-stage process to get it torqued down. The first torque setting is going to be 43.5 foot-pounds. And once you do it through that sequence, then the next sequence is to tighten each one 90 degrees in the same pattern. All right, guys, we've got our head torqued down, and the next thing we need to do now is go ahead and install our camshaft in the rocker box. All right, when you put in the camshaft, want to make sure, go ahead and put a little bit of oil on the lobes and the journals. So we definitely want that to be lubricated when it's starting up for the first time. All right, want to verify that your crankshaft is still at top dead center. And then initially, we just want the camshaft with the that little dowel pin facing up. Then we can go ahead and lay in our rocker box. And go ahead and get all of our rocker box bolts in there hand tight. And of course, there's a sequence. The sequence basically is they start from the inner and work their way out. So that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then these outer ones, 9 and 10, get done last. All right, guys, we got the rocker box torqued back down. The next thing we need to do is go through and go ahead and loosen up all the adjusters. I mean, I know we didn't replace the valves or anything like that, but what's gonna happen is when you bring that pin up to the 12 o'clock, it's gonna try to rock one way or another by virtue of the lobes, and that would make it very difficult to get the cam gear up there correctly. Because once we get those loosened up, then we bring our cam straight up, or that pin straight up, this is going to go in there and be in that position. And if it's off one tooth or another, we just need to pull it back off the cam, readjust the chain on the cam sprocket itself. All right, guys, we've got our valve lash set to zero. So you just want to make sure that each one of those just barely turns with your finger down at the bottom of the cup when it's in the relaxed position, just where it's making contact. And just one more time, verified we were at top dead center on the crankshaft as well as up on the camshaft. From here, what we need to do is just go ahead and put on our cam cover and then our thermostat over here. And then on the end, we've got that big stator cover, kind of heavy. Want to make sure that you don't forget this little rubber drive gear that goes right there when you're putting on the that outer cover. Other than that, that'll pretty much complete it. All right, guys, well, that's pretty much it. Went ahead and got this stator cover back on, went ahead and got the starter, went ahead and remounted it, so I didn't have to do it while it was in the frame. Valve cover's on, everything's tightened up, we're sure about the timing, we've got our new piston and rings in there, the valves look good, and this pretty much completes the reassembly of the engine. So what's left now? Well, we got to get this back in there. So that'll be our last video installment for this project. Listen, if there's something that I did that you couldn't see, or you have a question about something that I did, just if you would, leave it in the comments section below and I'll do my best to answer it. And if you need any of the parts or gaskets and whatnot that we use to put this engine back together again, come see us at partzilla.com. And until the next episode, we just want to say thanks for watching.